Okay, so we're going to look at a little algorithm to extract an initial, so a letter from a list of items from a larger 2D array or list that is in a CSV. Okay, so just here I've got a CSV of numbers, second names, first names, the film they're going to see, and the day they're going to see it. Okay, so this is my CSV of information. So this bit of code here, now I've just to explain, I've put this in a procedure just up here. So you don't necessarily have to have this, but I've just done it that way. So just this block of code here, what this will do, this will get the data from the CSV and it will append all of the data to a new list called data. Okay, we can check this by doing print data, and this should give us all of that CSV. Okay, there it is. Sort of squished up, but that's the entire CSV. So we know the CSV is now in our program. So as it's there, we can now start to do things with it. So the first bit of code down here, okay, I've kind of explained it in the comment, but basically I've got a new variable which I've called DB length, so database length, and this gives us the length of the list. Okay, so in other words, how many items are in the list. Okay. Now, we need this because what we're going to be doing is we're going to be picking a random item from the list, okay? So to do this, we're going to generate a random number between 0 and the length of the list, okay? So if there's 15 people in the list, it will generate a number between 0 and 15, okay? Now, I've put minus 1 on there because in a minute we're going to be using index numbers. And if there's 15 people in the list, the last person, the 15th person, the index number of their position in the list will be 14. So if we leave, if we don't have minus 1, it could generate 15, which would mean our list would be out of range. Okay, so far we've got a random number generated, which I have assigned the variable random name or rand underscore name. So again, we can check this works, okay, just by doing print rand name, it should give me a random number. Okay, there we go, 4. Just ignore the n for the moment. Okay, good. So I'll hash that back out. Okay, so next, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna get the randomly selected name from our list. Okay, so if you remember, here's our CSV, it's going to look in this column and it's going to get a random name from this column. Okay, now we can accomplish that by doing, I've made a variable called chosen name, and I've made it, I've assigned to it data, which is our list if you remember. So data is all of this. Okay, and I've said rand name. Now if you remember, that was the random number we generated. And then the next set of brackets means the column within our list. Okay, so in other words, column index position number 2. So to explain how this works, I'll go back to the CSV. This is column 0, this is column 1, this is column 2. So this is the reason I've got 2 in there, because it's going to look in column 2 and it's going to pick a random one from these using the random number we have just generated. Okay, and it's going to assign that name to the variable chosen name. Now, just to explain or show that working, I'm just going to go run this program. It should give us one of the names. There we go, Dave, and I'm just going to keep running it so you can see there, each time it's picking a random name from column number 2. Okay, 0, 1, 2. Okay, so a random name from each of these. Okay, so if we then want to pick a random, if we then want the initial from the name, okay, because sometimes we write a letter and we say like, Dear Mr. D Dangerous, or whatever the name is the initial. So it's useful to get an initial from a first name. So we can put the index number of the first letter in the name, and we do that by, rather than printing the whole name, we go chosen name and then in brackets 0, okay? And 0 is the first initial for that string. So if I go back here, it will look at J, D, J, N, B, and so on, okay? So if we now run this, what we will get is a load of initials, okay? So all of these initials have been picked randomly from our list of names from our CSV. So that's how we pick an initial at random from a list of people that are in a CSV.